Okay, so welcome back. We have to now program the change geo callback, okay? That will help us to store the data of all our geometric properties. Okay, but before we do that, there is one thing that, one behavior that have been annoying me, okay? So let me show you what I'm talking about. When I click on slap and I press escape, no big deal. Slap again and escape, it goes. Geometry, escape, it doesn't go. Okay, I don't know what's happening, but geometry escape does not go. It stays there and looks at me. It's supposed to vanish. So what we'll do is that certainly there is a form of change in behavior, because the sec window here is an array, okay? So it is adding elements as we go along. So it is important, I believe, that should be the error. If not, we'll look at that error in a different video. But we have to change the sec window. We have to bring it back to a scalar, okay? So that each time it's changing size, we have the appropriate size. We delete all the elements and then we bring it back to a scalar. So let's check whether that is actually the problem. So if I click escape, I click escape, I click escape, I click again, escape, I click again, escape. Okay, good. So that was the problem. Okay, so you had extra arrays that came there. So what happens? What happens is that when I click on geometry, okay, you will go to slab geometry, and what you notice is that in slab geometry, you have set window to be 3, 4, and 5. Okay, so if I click on escape in that particular case, in the first time, no problem, it will delete all the elements. Okay, why? Because all of it are handles. It will delete the elements, but it will not delete the values, that is the double values that are in sec window. I don't know whether you're getting me. Okay, it will not delete the double values that are, when I say double, double is the type, okay, that means the numbers that are in sec window. So it means that sec window will remain a 5-element array. Now, when you say if it's handled sec window, if sec window is an array, okay, this will only be executed if all of the elements in sec window are handles, right? So what happens when I go back to when I come back to draw element? Draw element only uses 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I have 4 handles. Okay, whereas sec window is already 5 elements. So it means the fifth element will no longer be a handle. And if the fifth element is no longer a handle, it means this condition will not be verified. Okay, so I need to make sure that I change the sec window back to become a scalar, so that each time I'm editing 1, 2, 3, 4, it is only the 1, 2, 3, it is only 1, 2, 3, 4. All the elements are always handles in sec window. It is either all the elements are handles or all the elements are not handles. Okay, so that was a parenthesis. Hope I'm giving you enough data here to be able to make research on your own to better understand all these concepts. So back to change geo. So you remember in the last video we created a global variable here. Global variable meaning that all the nested functions have access to them. So we created a variable here to control the geometry, okay, and I give it a value of 0. A value of 0, why? Because structures overload, okay, they overload double entities. And we also gave tag properties to all of our edit text, okay, because it is this particular callback that all our edit text in the geometry setup, all our edit text will execute the change geo callback. So we have to know on which edit text exactly we have clicked in order to know how to store that particular data. So what will I do? I will do switch. Okay, switch case. No, not case, sorry. Switch get source callback. right? So the first case, in fact, I will have cases, and let's put end. We'll be adding cases as we go along. So, what am I saying? Call back. Tag. Okay. So, what happens when I've edited? Let me go and do that because it's important. Oh, there is a mistake somewhere here. Let me put all of this in commentary. Can I have all of you in comments, guys? Okay, good. So, when I run this, if I go to geometry, I'm in the case of slab here, right? So this is the value I will be changing. It is this 20 here that I will be changing, right? This is the value I will be changing. And again, remember, we have the same problem here. We have to make sure that this value here is positive. It has to be positive, that is greater than zero, and it does not have to be a text. That is the only case where it should work. Okay? Good. So we even have an initialization problem here, okay? We have an initialization problem. Good. So listen, this is what we'll do. This is what we'll do. Sorry, I can foresee the future, okay? I can foresee the mistakes that may happen. Check the time. So what we'll do is that we'll not initialize our Joe here. We'll not initialize it to zero, okay? We'll initialize it to the initial... Where is the Joe? We'll initialize it to the initial properties. Okay? So what happens? We'll say switch here. We'll say switch case, okay? Should in case we are in column, or let me start as I always start, beam, or in the case of column, or in the case of what else, slab. What should happen? Well, we will have to initialize it. So what do we say? We say we are, when we are in beam, we should have Joe dot what h, right? We have initialized Joe dot h to be what 50, right? Joe dot what's that again? What's the next guys? Joe.hf, we said it is equal to 20. Okay. Joe.b, we said has to be equal to 70. And Joe.bw, bw have to be equal to 30, right? So now we can go to column. On column, we have just one data to enter, and it is a diameter, and it has to be equal to 30. And on slab, we have just one again, which is the thickness, which we have called h, and it has to be equal to 20, right? So all of this is initialized. We are okay with that, right? Okay, so let's ride. So we are in Joe now. Woo. Come on, bring me to change Joe. Okay, so now listen, we have to get the source tag. That means on which edit text have we clicked. If we have clicked on, if we have edited rather the slab edit text, that is the thickness, then we'll have the tag slab. Okay? If we have edited instead in column, and it is, for example, the column, the diameter that we have tried to change, then the tag will be column. If it is for beam, then when we want to change beam, the tag will be beam B. We want to change the width, it will be BW, and so on and so forth. So those are all the different cases that we have to outline here, okay? So, should in case we have the thickness of the slab, then the tag gotten here will be slab. The tag here will be slab, okay? So in case it is the column, then the tag here will be column. In case it is beam, we have four cases for beam. So we have the case where it is the beam H diameter, H parameter, sorry. The case where it is the beam HF parameter. The case where it is the beam, what's that? B parameter. And the case finally where it is the beam BW parameter. Okay? So, let me check the time here, please. Okay. So, perfect case scenario. Let us have the slab, for example. What do we have to make sure? We have to make sure that, come on. The very first thing we have to do is what? The user will have to enter a value, okay? And when the user enters a value, we have to collect that value. Okay, we have to get the value the user enters. And that value will be stored where? It will be stored in the string property of our source. Okay, remember source is the handle of the object whose callback is executing. So, of the source string. It will be given to us in the form of a character, but we need it as a number, right? To store it in our various variables. So we'll say get source. What am I saying? Get source. We'll need to convert it. So val will be equal to string to double, as we have seen. String to double of str. Okay? Now this is the var that we will save in our joe.h or joe.d or joe.bhf and all the like according to the text that we have selected. Okay, so we'll continue from here in the next video. Thank you very much.